Nights like this remind us how much we share. And so as we celebrate together, let us take a moment to appreciate all that Ireland has given to America. The faith we keep, the family we hold close, the laughter and song and warmth we feel when surrounded by the ones we love. On behalf of the American people, I want to thank the people of Ireland. In the years ahead, may our sons and daughters only grow closer. And now I would like to present to you the Taoiseach of Ireland. Happy St. Patrick's Day to all of you. Taoiseach.
Thank you very much, and happy St. Patrick's Day. Mr. President, thank you for your warm invitation to join you here this evening. Fionnuala and I are honoured on behalf of the Irish people and delighted to accept your invitation. On St. Patrick's Day, sometimes we remember some of our leaders. Michael Davitt, who began one of the great agrarian movements throughout Europe, the great Ulster clans of the O'Neills and the O'Donnells, the O'Connells of Munster. I've left a book on Daniel O'Connell for your protocol section, Mr. President. Dare I say it, the Obamas of Leinster. Certainly, if that's the case, I can tell you that in the history of the English language, never has a single apostrophe meant so much to so many. Yes, you see, there is no one as Irish as Barack Obama. And may I say, sir, Mr. President, they're queuing up in their thousands to tell you that in Moneygall when you visit us in May of this year. And I want to say this, sir, the news of your decision to visit Ireland in May has reverberated around the world already. They're causing a stir that you will see, sir, when you go there, that you will get a Caith Míle Fáilte, which is the 100,000 welcomes, the traditional welcome of the Irish people. I'd like to echo the words of the President, because as we gather here in the White House this evening, we do remember the various ways and the different journeys that people took to get here. The Irish, driven out by what we called an Gortha Mór, or the Great Hunger, when the potato crop from the New World failed. As the writer said, in scattered lines they make for the quayside. Their only sound, the slow slap of their soles on the emigrant flagstones. But you see, ours was not a self-contained journey. Because on another Atlantic coast, other people were waiting. Waiting to be herded into ships. Mothers soothing children, perhaps not even their own. Husbands calling for wives, wives calling for husbands. Two peoples on the far coasts of one ocean, where in the words of Seamus Heaney, tireless waves came glinting, sifting from the Americas. And that was Africa's Cape Coast and Ireland's Cape Clear. Two peoples who would cross that single dividing ocean. The Irish to freedom, the Africans to slavery. Though they didn't know it in time, theirs were the genes that would build this great country of the United States of America. They actually are the genes that unite us here in the White House this evening, designed by an Irish architect to claim and to celebrate St. Patrick, who came himself to redeem the soul of a people, and he was a slave. Mr. President, at Cape Coast Clear, you said, it seemed as if the walls were talking. They might well have said, respect, mercy, obligation, never again. Because I too believe in the intense, unyielding, but compassionate Patrick, that his life unites us here today, not only in our Irish ancestry, but also in our common heredity. As President Kennedy said about his family of man, 2 weeks before he passed away, if our society is to promote the family of man, then let us realize the magnitude of our task. In the places around the world, nobody knows that more than the man standing behind me, the President of the United States. Whether the family of man has to be promoted across the valleys of Kenya, or the mountains of Ireland, or the scattered islands of Indonesia, or in the wreckage of Japan with that country's difficulties at the moment, or whether, Mr. President, we have to take it to places that are still forgotten around the world. This is our task. This is the task of political leaders, because not only are we leaders, but also fathers and parents, teaching our children, our country's children, about duty and about obligation, the need to fight cruelty, the need to fight injustice and inhumanity, wherever it happens. Our stories indeed. Our stories indeed might be singular, but we do know that our destiny, our children's destiny, is a shared prospect. Do as I do, lead, teach by example, create a future from the unknown. We're glad, Mr. President, that you will visit us in a short time. I hope when you do so, your stay will symbolize the life-giving bond between Ireland and the United States of America. We are your gateway to Europe. And I say again this evening, that gateway is wide open and continues to be ready for business. Mr. President, we meet here in this historic building almost at the spring equinox, when new light returns to our lives. But you will come to us in May, the start of what was known as the Celtic Summer, or as we call it in the Gaelic language, in the Irish language, Baltana, the Feast of the Bright Fires. And when you do, sir, you will return to your own people, your own place. Mr. President, you will come, in a way, home to Ireland. So tonight, let me paraphrase the words of one more famous than I. Let the word go forth from this time and place. Let it go forth high and clear into the eaves of this great city, that the bonds between Ireland and America are as warm and as strong as they've ever been in the history of our two great countries, warm and strong and vigorous, and so they shall remain. Because we are united, inspired, sustained by our faith. Our faith, I might say, in the audacity of hope. Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you. God bless you, the people of America, and the work you do for the oppressed and the disadvantaged around the world. And thank you on behalf of the people of Ireland. My concluding words are these. I said to the President and the First Lady outside, I know now that miracles do happen. The fountain is green, and I've arrived in the East Room here in the White House. 1 week in office. Enough to build the world, that's what the Creator had. If we keep this up, Ireland will be great again inside a very short time.
All right, with that, everybody, go ahead and have a party.